He will be at the finish line. That's the promise from Boston bombing survivor Jeff Bauman. The Granite Stater opened up today about the past year and how life has changed so completely for him. Our Gene Mackin joins us. And Gene, he'll be there cheering on runners at the Boston Marathon Monday.
Jeff Bauman says he'll be there, especially cheering on the team running for him. He's also sharing what it was like the moment he lost his legs 1 year ago and how far he's come.
When Jeff Bauman looks at this image taken just moments after he lost his legs, he sees past the pain.
I just see three other people helping me out, saving my life.
In his book, Stronger, he shares the moments, almost in slow motion, leading up to the marathon bombing last year. He came in direct contact with Tamerlan Tsarnaev, so close that when he woke from surgery, he helped identify him.
This kid kind of nudged me from the back and tried to get by. He looked right at me and I looked right at him.
The explosion was deafening.
At first, no, I thought it was like a firework. It smelled like a firework, and then people were going. Then I just, it was so crazy. Like my ears were ringing and people were screaming, and then I realized I saw my legs and I was like, oh no, it's like, this is really bad.
He thought he was going to die until Carlos Arredondo took Jeff Bauman's life into his hands, pinching off the bleeding. Bauman lost both legs, but his life was saved. He became the face of survival, from the field at Fenway to the Costco in Nashua where he worked. People lined up recently to get his book signed and meet the man who defines Boston Strong.
It's really tough to be normal and be my old self. I'm trying to, like, I spent this whole year trying to find myself again. And
he proposed to the woman he was cheering on at the marathon last year. His fiance, Erin, is now expecting.
I just treat every day like it's kind of like my last, and I try to do everything I can. I think laughter is, like, key. I try to just find something funny in everything, and sometimes it gets me into trouble, but, you know, it's just something that I do.
And Bauman's book hit the shelves last week. It's already a New York Times bestseller. He says even through a book and interviews like this, there are no words to express his gratitude to the people who helped him through this past year. Live in the studio, Gene Mackin, WMUR News 9.